Yo, my people, it's Elms Two Times, and today we're reacting to Blind Dating vs. 8 Models by Kellex. And I can't wait to see this video because if you've seen the Sidemen's 20 vs. 1 with Kellex in it, you know exactly what I'm talking about. So, without further ado, let's get right into the video. But before anything, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Let me know what you react to next.
After my success on Sidemen 20 vs. 1, it's time for Blind Dating vs. 8 Models. But how will I fare this time?
Welcome. It's time to lift the curtain. Only a little bit though. Don't want to reveal too much too soon. They're all deadly silent. I like this.
This is a serious moment.
Yeah. Okay. Someone's got their toes out.
I hope it's like 8 completely random girls. Oh, it's a blind date. What am I saying?
Fuck. Should charge for that, really. Hello, everyone.
Hi.
I said, hello, everyone.
Hello.
Yes, I knew you were excited to see me slash not see me. It's Kellex versus 8 Models. I've got a serious question. I'm going to vote you off down the line, so best of luck. Let's get into the first question. Number one.
Yes.
If we were to go on a date and money wasn't an issue, what would we do?
I'm quite adventurous, so probably like, you know, fly to Paris or something.
Ooh, okay. Fly to Paris.
It's not the first time, but it would be fun.
So you've done this with another boy?
Yeah, I have.
All right,
red flag.
Okay. Number two.
Hi. Well, on our first date, I think we would go for jet ski. Imagine going on jet ski on Thames all around London, and then we would stop by
That's
in
a good
Soho,
answer.
And we would go for dinner.
I do dabble in a bit of jet skiing myself, you know. Yeah, I'm sure you saw
but
my last
from
video.
What I've heard, apparently the Thames is like really polluted and stuff. But you know what? It's not a bad shout.
You?
No.
We're off to a good start. Hello, number three.
Hi.
Money's no issue. Where are we going?
Well, I'm Australian, so probably back to Australia, so I can take you to all of my favourite places and restaurants.
I've never been to Australia, so I'll bear that in mind. Number four.
So we would go to the beach in Dominican Republic.
This is great. I love it already. You're all taking me to some mad places. Should we just all go? We'll go one by one. I'll do number two on Tuesday, number three on Wednesday next week.
Sure.
Who the hell did I just ask?
Number four. So
oh, wait,
five.
Is that like, if that's the new design for No Two Ways, the pink one, I'm a fan.
No.
Thank you. I really appreciate
You're
that.
You're welcome.
The helpful one in the group, the helpful one. Number five, hit me.
So what are we doing?
Yeah.
Well, I'm an adventurous person. I like activities. So probably like rent out a whole theme park. Are you an adventurous person?
Oh, yeah.
She's but black. I can tell by the voice.
Right now, if we get to the final stage, it might be. Hello, number six.
Hello. So in all honesty, anywhere outside of the UK for a holiday.
Money's no issue. Tell me, what are we doing?
In that case, everywhere outside of the UK.
Wow. That's it. Our first date never ends until the day we die. I like that. Number seven.
So, I feel like we're following a theme here, but I'd probably take you to Italy, show off my Italian skills.
Have you got a bit of Italian in you?
I do. Half in me, which right. sounds very wrong, but...
Okay, maybe you can put half your Italian in...
Oh, God.
Number eight, hello.
Hello. Basically, what I want to do is to immediately flee the UK.
Do girls in general just hate the UK? Why are you still here?
I think when you're from the UK, you just want to be anywhere else but the UK.
Okay, how do you vote people out that all say kind of the same thing about some amazing opportunity to leave this shithole? Question number two. I'd like you all to have a look down the line at your peers, and I want you to tell me one by one which number you think is the prettiest.
Ooh.
You're probably never going to see these girls.
That's actually really smart to say.
Again,
a lot
it's
of
been
egos.
Very lovely, but now we're fighting.
He's gonna be crushed.
Now we're fighting to the death, okay? So who is the prettiest girl behind the curtain, number one?
Can I say two?
No.
I think number four.
Number four. Number two.
I think every one of us has...
Didn't ask that, sorry. No, love that, but didn't ask. Ratioed. Who's the... That's cringe.
Very
who is
cringe.
The prettiest?
I think number four.
Number four has two votes. Wonder what number four is gonna say. Number three.
I think everyone. I don't know. Number two?
Number two. Number four?
Number one.
You know what? That is confidence. She's like, I've got two votes. I'll sling it at number one. Number five?
Number four.
Ah, okay. Yeah. Number six?
Number three.
Okay. Number seven?
Everyone's so different.
No.
I'm gonna go for six.
Number six. Okay. And number eight?
I really liked number two's vibe.
Shit. Now it's my turn. I am going to vote out... After some really careful consideration, I'm gonna vote out number eight. Ah, shit.
She's pretty.
Your first answer, I feel like, was the same as everyone else's, and you should have just said you'll take me to the moon or something like that. But yeah, thank you very much.
Kill me.
Okay, it's time to lift that curtain. So we're going to waist height now. I get to see what jeans, dresses, nothing. Oh, a dress, there we go. Imagine she's straight up wearing nothing. We'll start at the other end now. Number one, I'll give you some room to think on your answer. Number seven, what is your worst ever dating experience?
I'd say the worst that was like damaging was definitely a guy calling himself a chub.
Do I have a worst dating experience? None that I can think of.
Be chaser for being on a date with me and calling me a fat, chubby white girl.
That is fucking mad. I'm sorry, that is one of the most outlandish things I've ever heard in my entire life.
To me, it was as well.
Fuck, I'm thrown now. Number six. Number six, worst dating experience ever.
I'm a very awkward person. I don't really have, like, a lot of dating experience, so it has to be the time that I was stood up.
Number six, I would never do that to you.
Oh, thank you.
Number five.
This guy wanted to take me to the cinema, right? Guess when he showed up? An hour and 15 minutes later.
Number four.
So basically, I went on a date with
done that before.
A colleague, and I learned that he was in a relationship with my other colleagues.
And did anyone ever find out?
Yes, she did.
Did you fight her?
What? No, no.
And then you had to all go to work the next day?
Said apparently they fulfilled their position or something like that.
Well, he didn't fill your position.
Because he was kind of like a supervisor.
Number three.
I did go on a date where the guy ordered like starters with me and then told me he, at the end, didn't eat any and that I had to pay for them all, but I was there and he did eat them.
Well, if you see this...
That's crazy.
I can't name it shame.
Rob, if you see this, I think you owe number three some money. Two?
But one time I went on a date with this guy and he used to like tell me, oh, you are so beautiful and everything. And then he was like, oh, you totally look like my sister. You are totally like my sister. And then I was wondering, does he have a crush on his sister?
Did he also try and take you to like a laundrette for the stepsister? I'm stuck. Number one.
And I met the guy online and we went out for drinks and he was like, oh, let me buy us a bottle. And I was like, okay, cool. And then he was like, oh, you should cook for me sometime because I love cooking. I was like, yeah, we'll cook. And then he's like, let's do it tonight. And I was like, okay. So then I was like, if we do cook, doesn't mean that we're going to do anything else. And he was like, oh, but I did think we were going to do something else.
Classic.
And he didn't pay for anything that he said he would pay for. He was just like, oh yeah, let's split it now. And unmatched me.
Hey, maybe I'm not that bad.
Pretty traumatic. And now I've got to vote someone out based on their traumatic experience. I think I'm going to vote out number one. I'm sorry. Come through. I'm
sorry, she's pretty
I would
well.
Love your cooking. It would be great.
That's fine.
But online dating doesn't work. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Yeah, your eyes are stunning, by the way.
Thank you.
Are they real?
Yeah.
Ah, shit. Right, okay.
Thank you.
Wow. They're like cat size. Next question. This is for all the men out there. I know that some men can be quite insecure about size. I kind of want to settle it once and for all. I just want your personal opinions, being as honest as you can be. What is
size
the perfect
always matters.
Penis size? Number two.
You can have small, you can have big. It's how you use it.
Thank you. Number three.
For me, it is kind of about size.
That's why it's good to get a good variety of answers.
I would say like 6 or 7.
So it is about size and you're saying 6 or 7 is...
I don't know what size is, but just not small.
What's small? Sorry. All the men in the room are like, you should just whip a ruler out the next time. Bring a 30-centimeter ruler with you.
30 centimeters, we're not gonna need that.
Well, yeah, number four.
So honestly, like, I don't wanna sound like number two. It really, like, it depends, like, honestly. And also, sex is not just about penetration.
You're right, it's not. Part of it, though. Number five.
Sorry, not sorry, but size matters.
Yes, we wanna hear cold, hard facts.
Nothing smaller than 6 inches.
Nothing smaller than six. Number six.
I'm a very petite human being, and I'm very size relative. So obviously we're not talking micro, but had experiences and painful experiences. So I'm on the lower end of that scale,
damn.
If I'm honest.
Okay, yep. Number seven.
Have you ever heard of a boyfriend dick?
A boyfriend dick?
Yeah, so it depends what it's for. If it's a one-off, you can go bigger. But if it's a regular thing, You want a comfortable size, you know, 5, 6, 7.
To everyone at home, I'm sorry if you're sitting there feeling a type of way right now. I try, like, you know, there's some good answers. Look, not every girl is the same, is what we've established from this. Now, again, I need to vote someone off based on who wrote these questions. That was me. I really like the boyfriend dick answer. Mm. Let's take a sip of water.
Yeah, I never knew what that was.
Okay.
Apparently that's the thing.
Due to size needed to sustain a healthy relationship, I think I'm going to vote out, if my memory serves me correct, number 5. You know,
hey, I was right. You know, that's just pretty as well.
That's to be easy.
That's to be easy.
You know, there's certain standards that, you know, people, like, I mean, you know, but like, you know.
Yeah. I know. Yeah. I know. It's all right.
Yeah. But you just basically said, okay, all right. Well, congratulations on making it to waist high. We're now going up. Raise the curtain.
Raise that curtain.
Whoa. Okay. You can slightly see me now, can't you?
Yeah,
I know you can. So we've raised the curtains. I'd love to know, why did you choose to wear the outfits you're wearing today? Hi, number 7. Why did you wear what you're wearing today?
I definitely said raise the trip. Comfortable and like going out. I like to kind of glam up on one.
Let's rate the drip. Her out of 10, I'll give her 7.5. Nice fit. Is that Dunks? I don't know, but yeah, I like the fit. Her, I'll give her an 8. Nice fit with the Gucci belt. That's dreadful. That is dreadful. It looks like something a mum would wear. You can't even see what I'm. All right. So this one. The first one, I was gonna say, I'll give her like a 7.5. I like the fit. Her 8, I like the fit a little bit better. Looks more coordinated and stuff. Her dreadful. What is that? Give her a 2 or 3. Her simple. Give her a 7.5. Her simple again. I like it with the heels and shit. I'll give her a 7.
Side and then cash it down.
Yeah,
for the
I was
rest?
Gonna say you've glammed up top for sure.
I have.
Okay. Why have you worn what you've worn?
So essentially, I am one or the other in extreme. So it was either ball gown and stilettos, or it was super casual.
Before.
I chose this dress because it represents how I feel today.
How do you feel today?
Flowery, bubbly.
Just seems lovely.
I wore this outfit because it's my favorite outfit, and it fit into my work bag that I was carrying.
I like that. Practicality. Number 2.
So today I feel vibrant and full of energy, so that's why I put color on. And I didn't want to be too dressed up, so I put jeans on, but I also put heels to show you my toes.
I didn't even have to pay. And you've got a love heart there. Is that for me?
Of course.
Wow. Okay. Right. I am going to vote off number 6.
Hello.
She had the best. I've been better. One of the best trips.
Thank you, GoPro. That's the GoPro. Thanks. I liked your outfit, but I liked the story behind some of the others. I'm sorry.
Fair enough.
I'll let you have fun. I'll forgive you.
All right. Thank you.
She was pretty as well.
Down to 4. How are we feeling?
Feel alone.
Alone, yes, you are. I've learned about your outfits. I've learned a little bit about you guys. I've learned about size. But it is how you use that size. So is there anything that you girls wouldn't do in the bedroom? Number 2.
So one thing I would not do is to stay in bed whole day and whole night, not doing anything, just laying or sleeping, because I'm a fun person and I don't like to be boring.
Number 3.
I think that I understand the question a bit more, and I think that I probably wouldn't do anything that like is gonna cause severe pain. Maybe candle wax. I've seen that in movies. Probably.
Is that a no-go?
It probably hurts more than it feels good, so I would have to say no candle wax as my.
Oh shit!
Damn it!
Out
I go.
That candle wax. Number 4.
So honestly, I would try pretty much anything. Just because, you know,
she's
why
a
not?
Freak.
Candle wax.
I'd have to try it one time. So, yeah, I guess. So.
Number 7.
Again, I'm pretty much down to try anything, but I hate feet. So I don't want to touch yours and I don't want you to touch mine.
So toe sucking's out of the agenda.
Oh, no.
Are you not into that?
You've said so many times about seeing toes for free today. So I just assumed you're into feet. I am.
I have to vote out 2 of you now. Obviously, toes have been a big theme of today, but you're safe for now. Number 2, however, I think you misunderstood my question. And unfortunately, by way of technicality, I have to vote you out. Hello. Hey. Thank you. I heard the all
she's
day.
You know, she looks like thing. She looks like the girl from Victorious, like the main character. She's exactly like her. Remember that show, Nickelodeon?
I wasn't joking about the feet thing. I'm sorry, number seven. I'm gonna have to vote you out.
That's fine.
Really important to me. Need some good toe play.
To me, it's not.
Thank you so much, though.
No worries.
And hopefully, you indulge in more of that kind of stuff soon.
I will
that you
never.
Really?
Ever, ever. Okay. Feet are vile. I'm sorry, though. I hope you find your queen with their foot fetish.
Yeah. Me. Thank you. Thanks. We're down to two. How are you both?
Good.
Do you like my pink shoes? Number three.
I like my shoes better.
Oh, they are no two ways. I like them.
Do you like my pink shoes, number four?
I do. I think it inspires
Pink Panther.
Now we've got a round where I just want to see who kind of has that burst.
She was
like,
voted the prettiest.
Who's
so
down
I
for anything.
Can't
so
wait to see how she looks.
I just wondered if either of you would like to rap.
I'll do it.
Do we both have to do it?
You don't both have to do it. Obviously, it's a voting contest.
Oh, gosh, okay. Why not?
So, number four, what's your name?
Alison.
Alison, number three?
Jess.
Alison, you said that you would like to rap Super Bass by Nicki Minaj.
Yeah.
I've got like an instrumental up here. You can just play it yourself. Copyright. Okay, here's Super Bass by Alison.
This one is for the boys in the booming system. Top down, we seat with the coolest system. When he coming in the club, people blazing up. Got decks on the deck like he's saving up. And he heal, he real, he might get a deal. He bought bottles and he got a right kind of bill. He call, he dope, he might sell coke. He was on a hill, but he never walked like coke.
Yo.
That's a classic,
wow.
To be fair.
Okay, there's no way that I can rap now.
No, but I really wanted to hear the cute little family song. It's good in a different way, but that was very impressive.
It's not very long because I forgot half of it. Sorry, family. But okay, ready?
Yes.
I'm in Manly with my family, getting all sandy. When we got home, my dad said, "Hey kids, are you dandy? Oh, something handy? I don't know." Done.
Okay, all right. Right, we're going to have one final round. Look, you've both been great today. It's a very hard decision, and I want to make my decision a little bit easier. I just want you both to kind of just chat to each other and debate why I should pick you and not the other person. I'm pitting you against each other to the death.
Well, Alison has a date tomorrow night with someone else, so she will be cheating on you.
Wow. Okay.
What a fed.
Alison, how serious is this date tomorrow night?
Honestly, I would have to see. In my defense, Jess has a boyfriend, so she would be cheating.
Oh, my God.
I don't.
Oh, you don't?
No.
You did.
No, I don't have a boyfriend. I said I don't want a boyfriend. Oh.
Okay. Is that all
I'm
you'd like
dead.
To say?
After that, I think so.
I think it's decision
time. I'm here for
you
it. I love it.
Been phenomenal. My brain cells are now deliberating who they're going to pick to go on this date. And I think I'm going to go with number four. Hello, number three.
Hello.
Lovely to meet you.
Lovely to meet you.
Funny to see you. We've been chatting. Oh. Number four, come through. Say hello.
This see you the winner.
You that I've chosen. Hello.
Yeah.
You are beautiful.
Thank you.
I think I've made the right decision.
I reckon she
you
was
ready for
a prettiest.
Our date? Shall I set it up for us?
Yeah.
Cool, let's go. Cheers.
Chin chin.
Chin chin. I knew that you loved red wine, so I got you red wine.
Thank you.
White's your favourite, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Right, okay. What do you think? I'm here now.
Yeah, you look nice.
I look nice. How's the dress? I've tried today. I've dressed up for the occasion. I knew that it was going to be you, so obviously I wanted to dress to impress, like yourself. Where do we go from here? What does our future look like? You've just moved over here. You've got a date in 2 days. She grassed you up.
Yeah, she did.
Who's the date with?
It's with an ex-colleague, so.
An ex-colleague. You know that never goes down well.
I mean...
Is it a first date?
Yeah, it would be.
It's a first date, yeah. So it's something that can be, you know...
Let's not talk canceled. About him. Let's talk about you.
Okay. What do you look for in a guy?
A connection, so something deeper, kind of spiritual, that they believe in something.
Yeah, love and God. Does spiritual have to mean religious, or does it mean... does it mean
no.
anything?
No, it means... That you believe in anything or in an energy or that there's something
everything happens for a reason.
Yeah
there's no two ways in life, there's no two paths. thank you. I also like my girls spiritual and French. Got a soft spot for French girls.
Ah,
Good. Femme la bouche.
La bouche.
Actually, a Canadian French, Québécois. So, yeah, there's a
difference. What in how you say shut up? It's what is different.
See, I know French as well.
I say femme la.
So, what kind of energy are you getting off me?
Well, I think you like to make jokes.
I try.
And I find that funny.
Where should we go next, then?
Let's go to Italy.
You have some free time coming up?
Yeah, I do, actually. I'm self-employed, so.
Same here. Yeah. I'm very self-employed.
Yeah.
So self-employed that I'm employed. Now, my friends the Sidemen, do you know the Sidemen?
No.
They're cool guys, and they do like this discount code thing in their videos. So is there any chance you could come up with a discount code, because Apricities are now available on the website.
Oh, that's the first, yeah. Available the first now. Edition. These,
not available yet, but they will be, but these... Available now. All right, we're going to do a 20% discount code, and the code is
CalixWorld9345.
CalixWorld9345. Cool, thank you. No, that's good. That's good. Cheers. Cheers to all that discount, Alison.
Yes.
It's time.
It's time.
It's time for the game.
Now it's time for date or mate. The rules are simple. I'll give you a second to read them. But will she win the grand prize?
If you both choose their date, and mate, let's choose mate. What to choose? Okay, I'm gonna make a prediction. They're gonna both choose date. Because it's better if it's both of them.
And money, or will Calyx be bankrupt and friend zoned?
Thank you for that lovely voiceover. Do you understand? Did you hear the voiceover as well?
I did. Yeah.
Good. I reckon he likes it as well.
So you write date or mate. Date to date, and mate, you friend zone me. It's been a long day.
Okay.
Are you ready? Let's reveal to the camera whether we both want to date or mate.
Hey. Woo!
Yes, come on. This is yours.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Woo!
Maybe we can put it towards our date.
Yeah, sure.
You said, what did you say?
I said like 2 plane tickets for Italy.
Yeah, is that put to a side?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then restaurants, and then hotel for 2 days. And then this is just fun or whatever.
Great. What a result. All that. all those dates down to this moment. Hope you enjoyed. Maybe we'll see you soon.
Okay, this is 4 seconds.
When do you want to book it?
Like after.
Sure and sweet. Okay, well, that was the video. Make sure you comment, like, and subscribe, and I'm out.